Rana, fondly called Rana Pa by many, has been a historian for a long time, a historian of medieval history. She's off late, should we say the last 5 years? About 7-8 years. She has been passionately documenting Delhi's history, particularly forgotten histories. She has a very lively blog and a very lively Twitter handle. And all those who follow her will also know about her books and her videos. Saba, of course, is a very well-known filmmaker, but many of us got familiarized with her work when, you know, when there were waves of communal violence and she started the campaign, Not In My Name. She has now written a book called Tawaif Nama, which has been the result of almost 20 years of work, 19, something like that.
There's a film also.
Yes. Yeah. So, yeah. So, we'll straight away get to the questions. Both of you have put in a lot of time and effort working on erased histories. You on the hidden parts of the city and Saba on marginalized and stigmatized communities that you have followed. Tell us how and why they became a passion for you.
Especially a country, a city like Delhi, which has a continuous history of over 1,000 years, and you've had so many dynasties here, so many rulers, so many kings who have come, ruled here and gone, and of course the ordinary people, the citizens who've lived here, the residents. It's just full of monuments. There are over 1,300 monuments in Delhi. And each monument, some of them of course now are collapsing, but each monument has a story to tell. And I realized that, you know, when we see a monument, we just see brick stones, or maybe we'll see it's a dome or a steeple, or, you know, it's a rectangle or a square or oblong. We see it in architectural terms. But if that piece of architecture has a history hidden behind it. So that history beckoned me, and I've always been fascinated by monuments. And that is why I decided to write about it, that what happened within or near this particular place that I am standing in. Because it's only when the stones speak to us that it can speak to others and call them to come and look after it and take care of monuments which are falling apart.
Evidently, because both of you, I think you've breathed life into history. Their history is not really the history that we've read in the classroom and been bored by. It's living history. What about you?
Well, I have, as a filmmaker, my work has largely focused upon issues related to gender, sexuality, and of course, identity-based politics and culture. And I think women's lives have always interested me. Women's struggles, women's lives, women's role in history. And you know, the thing is that it's not that I really thought about tawaifs and I said I want to work on them, because although they are these, you know, you see them in Bollywood, they are so beloved of Bollywood, but if you really think about it, there's not very much known about them. But I was not looking at them. Way back in 2000s, I was working on a film around the history of women of my own family, which is a middle class family, and looking at their struggles. And a lot of my films are very research-based. So while I was researching for it, you know, especially late 19th century educational reforms, that's where I came across references to tawaifs. And by a strange coincidence, it was around that time that I visited Ujjain and actually met a family of tawaifs. I was at a certain place interviewing some people, and, you know, there were these ladies who's, you know, very, with a lot of grace and poise and confidence. And I remember feeling, having a sense of shock, because I said, ki, tawaifs I knew. I said, ki, yes, of course, but they're creatures of the past. I mean, to think that there are people who can, you know, who till, say, about 10 years back were in the, were tawaifs was, So that's how actually I started work. I also realized that while I started looking at the history of tawaifs, I couldn't really understand the history of middle-class women and the struggles they have put in, unless I also understand the history of tawaifs. You know, within patriarchy, women are the other of patriarchy. And tawaifs are the other of the other. So these are histories that are interlinked and they had to be understood.